It's the Pav Bamber here for PSB Sports with the JD NXT Gen Hair Show today at York Hall. I'm joined by Ted Cheeseman, who was victorious on the card. Ted, firstly, congratulations. What's your assessment of the performance?
It's a really good performance. I had a good, tough opponent, a durable opponent who I've got to work on. A lot of stuff I've been working on in the gym, and I showed him that I've got a great punch variation, and I felt like I put a good, mature performance on, so that's all is what I wanted.
Yeah, I mean, obviously, there's a lot of, you've got some plenty of winning fights now under your belt, you know, you're getting more and more experience as you go along, and obviously you're very active as well, so how important is the activity, do you believe, in helping you become the established fighter that you are?
Yeah, to be honest, I'm trying to not take such an easy route of journeyman after journeyman. Like you said, I've already fought quite a few winning record fighters, and that's the way you improve. I had a good amateur career, and I've been working in the gym around a lot of good fighters, so obviously I want to push on as quick as I can, but it's about my management team and what they want to do. And I'm only 22, so I've got to take my time, and everything will come as it should.
Yeah, I mean, you know, I mean, I know a fellow gym mate of yours, Conor Benn, he obviously made his debut this year in July, so he first fought in July, but he said that the reason why he took time out is because he obviously wanted to get more experience, wanted to learn different things in the gym. So what sort of things do you pick up in the gym under the tutelage of Tony Sims?
You've got someone there looking at all your mistakes all the time and trying to put them correct. And to be honest, like in September, I was 2 years as a pro. And from my debut to now, you can see like a hell of an improvement. So that's what it's all about. As long as you keep improving, as long as you keep winning, that's the main thing.
Absolutely, and obviously there's 2 months left of this year. You've had a very busy 2017. I mean, you've been fought on the massive Hay versus Bo Yonder card and things like that. You've been a regular on the NXT Gen show, so you expect to be out again this year?
Hopefully, I'm pushing to try and get on the Hay Bellew bill on December 17th, and fingers crossed the British belt becomes vacant and the final eliminator turns to the British title, a vacant British title fight.
Yeah, I mean, I think we've actually interviewed before and you said that you wouldn't actually mind boxing Joe Pickford for the British title.
Yeah, Joe Pickford, but obviously now it looks like it's going to be either JJ Metcalf or Damon Jones who are in the other eliminator, so once that eliminator is done, obviously Liam Williams has got to vacate, but as soon as it's vacated it will go to Perth, vacant belt, so as soon as it comes along, I'll take my chance, but I think I'm hoping for it to be on the Hay Bellew bill.
Absolutely. Well, Ted Cheeseman, once again, congratulations on the victory here at York Hall on the NXT Gen card, and obviously, fingers crossed, we can hear some positive news soon, maybe about your next fight, as you mentioned, maybe on the Hay Bellew undercard.
Yeah, cheers. Thanks a lot.
Thanks a lot. Nice one, Ted.